गुड मॉर्निंग टू ऑल। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस टू फाइंड द वोल्टेज रेगुलेशन बाय यूजिंग MMF मेथड, और इट इज़ आल्सो कॉल्ड एज रोदर्स और एम्पेटेंस मेथड। सो सिंपली MMF मीन्स व्हाट? MMF मीन्स मैग्नेटो मोटिव फोर्स। सो वी हैव वन फार्मूला, दैट इज अ बेसिक फार्मूला। MMF यूनिट इज एम्पियर टर्न्स। एम्पियर मीन्स I, टर्न्स मीन्स N। सो हियर जस्ट अज्यूम द नंबर ऑफ टर्न्स आर कॉन्स्टेंट, so automatically MMF is directly proportional to the field current or normal current. So here this field current is proportional to the MMF. That is the main concept of this method. So this method also, so we have two testings, that is a OC test and AC test. So simply first OCC curve and AC characteristics curve. So simply this y-axis represents the induced MMF and x-axis represents the field current, or it is the MMF axis. Okay, x-axis represents the field current or MMF axis. This y-axis represents the EMF, induced MMF. Okay, next to first to draw the OCC characteristics. OCC characteristics draw in between the induced MMF versus field current. So OCC characteristics drop in between induced MMF versus field currents. Next to SC characteristics, draw in between the field current versus ISC, I mean field current versus short circuit current. Okay, so first of all draw the OCC curve. First initially field current is zero, then induced MMF also zero. Simply field current is increases, induced MMF also increases. So from that values to draw the OCC curve. Next come to the SC test. SC test means just apply the short circuit current. Apply the short circuit current, then note down the field current. So from these values to draw the SC test. SCC characteristics, short circuit characteristics. Okay. Next after that to denote the two points IFA and IFM. IFM means the main field current. IFM means the main field current required to produce the rated voltage under OC test. So from this OC test, so we are taking the IFM points. Okay, so in this IF value you got the some rated voltage in the voltmeter. So that is the IFM points. Next IFA means, so this one also the main field current required to produce the armature current, to produce armature current in the AC test. That is the IFA and this is the IFM. So first of all, from the IFM point to draw the one vertical line up to OCC curve. After that, so from this point horizontally draw the one more dotted line, then you got the rated voltage value. Okay, so this is the one point. Next after that IFA means, so this is the main field current required to produce the armature current in the AC test. So from this point to the other one more vertical line up to AC curve. Then after that from this point to draw the horizontally one more line up to this field current. This is the current that current is called rated, that current is called the rated current. It is also called as short circuit current. Okay, so you got IFA and you got IFM. From these two vectors you got the IFT. How means? First we are assuming the lagging load, so this is the one IFM vector. Next this is the simply induced MMF E. Then lag means this is the IFA. So V lags IFA. So this is the IFA. The vector resultant between IFM and IFA, you got the total field current. Total field current. If suppose IFM is a 2.5 amperes, this is the some 1.5 amperes. So then you got some resultant field current. Okay. Finally, from these two values IFM and IFA value, you got the total field current. So So you got the total field current, then you got some points. So from these points to the one more vertical line up to OCC curve, then after that, after this point to the one more horizontal line up to induced EMF line, that is the y axis, then you got the E naught. So from this E naught you got the voltage regulation. So finally, this is the formula for voltage regulation, E naught minus V by V. So this E naught from this graph, E naught, then E naught minus V means you know the voltage, that is the full load voltage divided by E naught minus V by V into 100. So finally you got the voltage regulation. So this vector diagram for unity power factor, unity power factor means, so IFA in phase with E. So the vector relation between IFM and IFA, you got the IFT. So this is the complete unity power factor. Then leading power factor, this is the IFM vector, this is the E vector. So E leads IFA, the angle in between E and IFA, that is a pi. So the vector relation between IFM and IFA, you got the IFT. So finally, MF method, it is a optimistic method. Why? Because you got the less than the actual value. So this method is the optimistic method. Okay, thank you.